Hi, I'm Catherine Mayer with Human Resource Executive Magazine. And I'm excited to be joined today by...
Hi, I'm Laura. Laura Hamill. I'm the Chief People Officer and Chief Science Officer at Limeade.
Great. So why don't you tell us a little bit, for those who aren't familiar with Limeade, tell us what Limeade is.
Yeah, Limeade is an employee experience technology company. We focus on well-being, employee engagement, inclusion, and communications. We bring that all together and really offer a way for employers to show their employees that they care about them.
Very cool. So, you know, those are big buzzwords when we talk about employee engagement, we talk about well-being, communication, that kind of thing. And here we are, HR Tech.
Yeah.
Tell me exactly why you think that those components are very important, and to do so, you know, via a technology route as well.
Yeah, for sure. HR in general in the past has focused so much more on compliance and process. And what we're really trying to get to are the things that can matter the most about being a great place to work. So we think that, and the evidence, the science and the evidence suggests, that those things, well-being and engagement and inclusion and communications, those are the things that really hold people in organizations. They're the things that make people attracted to a culture and want to stay in a culture. So we think they're probably some of the most important things to focus on. And in the past, we haven't focused on them in technology as much in terms of a platform, right? And so what we do with Limeade is not only do we measure those things, but we also have an action engine, a way for employers to actually improve in those areas. Mm-hmm. We think that's probably just as or more important than measuring those things.
Yeah, very interesting.
Yeah, thanks.
So, you know, you've been doing this for quite some time.
Yes.
So I'm just curious, here we are
again. Almost 14 years.
That's amazing.
Yeah, it's crazy.
You know, again, here we are at HR Tech. This conference is huge. There's so much going on. I'm just curious, from your experience of being in this market for so long, what kind of transformations have you seen over the 14 years that you've been doing this?
So much. Yeah. It's so encouraging, actually. Sometimes I have to remind myself, right, when we have a hard day or when things are feeling tough, got to remind myself of there's been a ton of progress. And what I mean by that is when we first started in this space and we would talk about the idea of caring about the quality of life of your employees, people would laugh at us. People would tell us we were crazy.
Yeah.
People told us, oh, you know, you shouldn't focus on stress. Stress has nothing to do with work. And that was only 14 years ago, right?
Yeah.
Literally that happened to us. And so it's so neat to see the progress, to see that not only HR leaders, but CEOs are starting to realize how important it is to care about your people as people. And then when you do that, not only is it the right thing to do, but that it's better for your business if you do that.
Absolutely. That's a great transition because, you know, you have done this research on this thing that you call the science of care. And I know that new research has been released on that, talking about the business impact of showing employees that their company, what you say, authentically cares about them.
Yeah.
So explain to me exactly what this science of care is and why, again, this is so, so important right now.
So one of the functions that I'm responsible for is called Limeade Institute. Mm-hmm. And Limeade Institute actually does primary research studies and secondary research studies on topics like well-being, engagement, inclusion, and culture, and things like that. So what we decided this year is to actually focus our efforts on this idea of care. And what we think is that the concept of care is sort of an overarching one. It's one that really summarizes what we're trying to do in our product. And when we look at the academic literature, there's a lot of really great academic support for this idea of care and support of our employees.
Absolutely.
So we decided to do some of our own research to dig into that. One of the motivations behind doing the research was really to address those people we call care naysayers. So they're the kind of people who say, you know, the way I show you that I care is that I give you a paycheck every 2 weeks. That's how I show you I care.
Exactly.
Or the business, you know, business isn't about feelings. We're trying to really address those people head on with some science to say, not only is it the right thing to do, but it's better for your business. Let me show you through research and evidence that it is. And so in the research that we did, it's a big research study, so there's a lot to it. But just to give you a couple headlines, what we found is that the concept of care, so feeling like your organization cares for you, is related to recommending your company as a great place to work. It's related to intentions to stay in your organization. It's also negatively related to stress and burnout. So we found things that you probably would expect, but it's really neat to see the science and evidence behind it.
Absolutely. All really, really big issues that we're talking about right now. And it's funny because when we talk about, you know, caring for employees, it seems so obvious, right?
Yes.
But, I mean, I feel like a lot of employers don't really recognize that.
Completely.
So, you know, what would you say to some of these people, you know, to employers, to HR professionals, yeah. who you're trying to convince that this is an important, important issue?
So what I say is, do you have a retention problem?
Yeah.
Do you have an attraction problem? Because if you're saying that, I bet you do. Honestly.
Yeah.
If you don't get that treating people right and caring for them and valuing them as human beings, I'm betting it has an impact on your culture. And you're probably not getting the people results or the business results that you really want. So I would encourage you to kind of look in the mirror and think about, gosh, is this whole field of HR way more than these compliance things, these process things? Isn't it about fundamentally valuing human beings?
Yeah.
And what is your organization doing in real tangible ways to do that?
Absolutely. Those are great messages. Thank you so much
yes,
for talking
absolutely.
About this.
Thank you. Very fun.
Great.